kill the endangered animal. Yes, it looks like he's dragging him through the water, but some witnesses say the gorilla was actually trying to protect the boy. So did the zoo officials make the right call? Here to weigh in is the director emeritus of the Columbus Zoo and Aquarium, Jack Hanna. Jack, great to see you. Welcome back to the show. Did the zoo make the right call here in putting down this gorilla?
They did, but let me say 10 seconds and say something if I could, please.
Sure.
Remember something. The Hanna family, the Columbus Zoo, the Cincinnati Zoo, and the zoo world, we literally love this animal more than anybody could ever imagine. All of us do, like every animal. However, we've also given millions of dollars to the gorillas, both mountain and lowland gorillas in the wild, to save these animals. And you know what? Thanks to our money, we've saved them in the wild. However, this gorilla, you know, when you look at what happened there at the Cincinnati Zoo, could really happen anywhere, whether it's a zoo or whether it's a race or whether it's a water park or amusement park, whatever it might be. And what happened here, what they had to do had to be done. Why is that? I heard in my ear that if people watch what happened, they heard the screaming going on. This is a silverback male, by the way. This isn't a female gorilla. And the silverback has a kind of responsibility to take care of his family. I have a home right next to gorillas in Rwanda, 2 miles from where the gorillas live in Rwanda. I've seen the gorillas since 1982, both lowland gorillas and mountain gorillas. These animals, these silverback males, the power they have, they can take a green coconut and squish it like a marshmallow. You can't even bust one up with a hatchet. The animal's power is beyond belief. We know that 6 full-grown men cannot even handle a chimpanzee full-grown. So we wouldn't, the gorilla, I'm trying to tell you, when all that screaming's going on, this thing just plops in there, which is the young child. What is this? What is this? So he grabs the child, runs him through there like that. That was a dead giveaway for me. You're talking milliseconds now, especially if that dart tranquilizer were to hit the gorilla, what would you do? Now, I've seen researchers in the wild work with gorillas. I've seen other animals. When it pops them, it's like you're getting a shot. You jump, obviously. And obviously, it takes 5 to 10 minutes for a gorilla to go to sleep.
Okay, so that's an important point, that tranquilizer. That's an important point that people saying, well, why not a tranquilizer dart? You're saying because it would have maybe made him angrier and could have killed the boy?
Yes. Well, more than likely, what would you do if you had a shot just come up and you're sitting there talking to somebody and somebody pops you in the butt with a big old shot? You're going to jump, aren't you? I hope you would, especially if you hit a nerve or something. I mean, this is something right. That's a no-brainer. This animal could have literally taken that boy. And I wouldn't even want to describe it. So there was not a millisecond to waste on this. There's animal life and there's human life involved here, everyone. And obviously, someone said, well, can the Cincinnati Zoo or Columbus Zoo or any of our zoos do better? Safety is our number one priority in our parks. The visitor, the animals, our employees, we practice hours and hours every week. All the American Zoo and Aquarium Association, we were required to practice safety all the time. I don't know what happened here. I don't know where the mother was. I can't blame it on her or anybody. I don't know what happened. But, you know, how safe can we build a racetrack or a water park or a amusement park? How safe do we have to go? We have a responsibility, all of us do, with our families, and we do the best we can.
Yeah, we're almost out of time. 5 seconds, 10 seconds here. I mean, unfortunately, I wish we could talk about this all morning long. This idea, though, that the parents maybe were neglectful, where do you come down on that?
Well, I don't know. We have children, hundreds of children in our zoos and summer camps. We monitor the children, and I'm sure the parents, maybe the mother was distracted by something. I don't know, but you, as a parent, you go to the zoo or a shopping center or a water park or wherever, you have to take care of them.
Yeah. Jack Hanna, great to see you. More Fox and Friends coming up in a few moments. Thanks so much, Jack.